Hello, brothers and sisters. This is Christina speaking. Today is March 12, 2023, and I hope you are doing well. And so I have a message from the Lord, but before I share it, I want to confess that I believe Jesus Christ is the Son of God who has come in flesh on earth and died for our sins and was buried and rose on the third day. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm going to share with you the message from the Lord today, which is Joel chapter 2. I am going to read only verse 1, 2, 12, and 13. But the Lord wants you to read the whole scripture in order to understand this very important message. Joel chapter 2, verse 1 and 2. Blow the trumpet in Zion, and sound an alarm in my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord is coming, for it is at hand. A day of darkness and gloominess, a day of clouds and thick darkness, like the morning clouds spread over the mountains. A people come great and strong, the like of whom has never been, nor will there ever be any such after them, even for many successive generations. The Lord wants me to repeat this message. Blow the trumpet in Zion, and sound an alarm in my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord is coming, for it is at hand. A day of darkness and gloominess, a day of clouds and thick darkness, like the morning clouds spread over the mountains. A people come great and strong, the like of whom has never been, nor will there ever be any such after them, even for many successive generations. Verse 12 and 13. Now, therefore, says the Lord, turn to me with all your heart, with fasting, with weeping, and with mourning. So rend your heart and not your garments. Return to the Lord your God, for he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, and of great kindness, and he relents from doing harm. Now, therefore, says the Lord, turn to me with all your heart, with fasting, with weeping, and with mourning. So rend your heart and not your garments. Return to the Lord your God, for he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, and of great kindness, and he relents from doing harm. Brothers and sisters, the trumpet is about to sound. The trumpet is about to sound. The rapture is about to happen. The message in Joel chapter 2 is a call to repentance. The Lord wants you to read both Joel chapter 2 and chapter 3. Joel chapter 3 is about the judgment that is coming. I hope you who have been watching my videos, you are watching, praying, and ready every day. The time is almost over. I hope you are keeping your eyes fixed on Jesus Christ alone in doing what he wants you to do until the end. the Lord talked about Nahum chapter 3. Nahum chapter 3. He said that the whole world is busy with violence, deception, and idolatry. For this, the judgment of God is coming. Behold, I am against you, says the Lord of hosts. The Lord reminds us of the principle of 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 5. Be close with humility, for God resists the proud, but gives grace to the humble. The Lord said that many are walking in pride, and as a result, He is against them. He said that the leaders of this world are weak. The judgment is coming upon the wicked. In Ezekiel chapter 2, verse 7, the Lord said to me, "You shall speak my words to them, whether they hear or whether they refuse, for they are rebellious." This is Ezekiel chapter 2, verse 7. Also, the Lord talked about two groups of people who will be judged. 2 Thessalonians chapter 1, from verse 6 to 10. According to the Apostle Paul, the Lord Jesus Christ will take vengeance on those who do not know God and on those who do not obey the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Two groups of people will be judged. The first group are those who do not know God. Brothers and sisters, if you have not given your life to the Lord Jesus Christ, turn to Him right now. Receive and accept Him as your God and Savior. Believe that Jesus Christ is the only begotten Son of God who has come in flesh on earth and died for our sins and was buried and rose on the third day, and repent all your sins before it is too late. Unless you are born again, you will not enter into the kingdom of heaven. Get baptized of water and spirit. Be baptized in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Matthew 28, verse 19. That is what the Lord Jesus Christ commanded me to say. Before you get baptized, you need to understand why you are getting baptized. Very, very important. Being born again means you believe in Jesus Christ, you obey Him, and you keep His commandments. In John 14, Jesus says, "If you love me, keep my commandments." Hebrews 12, verse 14 says, "You must make peace with all people and live a holy life. If you do these two things, you will see the face of the Lord God, Jesus Christ, our God and Savior. Jesus Christ is the only way to heaven. There is no other way. John 14, verse 6. Without Jesus Christ, you are nothing and you will not be saved. The second group that will go through the judgment are those who do not obey the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. I have talked about obedience in my last message. Without obedience, we cannot please God. You must obey the word of God, the gospel. You must believe in the word of God, because the word is God. God is the word. Luke chapter 5, verse 31 to 32. Jesus answered and said to them, "Those who are well have no need of a physician, but those who are sick. I have not come to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance." Brothers and sisters, I hope you are ready. I hope you have found God, Jesus Christ, our God and Savior. I hope you have given Him your life. I hope you have made the right choice. The end is coming. Please share this video. God bless you.